towards an on-time liftoff. This morning's launch is part of the America Strong series, a collaborative salute from the Space Force and ULA to recognize healthcare workers, first responders, and other essential personnel. We'll talk more about this in a few minutes. Jessica Williams, the 45th Space Wing's weather officer, recently briefed the launch team on current weather conditions here at Cape Canaveral. The probability of violating launch constraints is 80%. The ground winds are 18 to 23 knots out of the northeast, and the temperature is 76 degrees Fahrenheit. So the weather is currently no go, and we are still planned T0 for the 8:24 a.m. Eastern. At the request of our customer, this morning's live coverage will conclude following confirmation of engine start on the Centaur upper stage. In addition to the orbital test vehicle, today's flight also includes FalconSat 8, an educational platform for cadets carrying 5 experimental payloads that will be operated by the Cadet Space Operations Squadron from the U.S. Air Force Academy and sponsored by the Air Force Research Laboratory. We also have 2 NASA experiments to study the results of radiation and other space effects on a material sample plate and seeds to grow food. And we have an experiment from the Naval Research Laboratory to transform solar power into radio frequency microwave energy, which could then be transferred to ground. Let's take a look at the events from liftoff through main engine start. And liftoff of the United Launch Alliance Atlas V rocket.
The Atlas V RD-180 engine ignites and generates 3.83 meganewtons, or 860,200 pounds of thrust, to lift the rocket away from the pad. Shortly after liftoff, Atlas begins a pitchover to attain the proper flight path while minimizing the pressure the vehicle experiences during flight. Within the first couple minutes of flight, the Atlas V reaches Mach 1, the speed of sound. Approaching payload fairing jettison, the Atlas V is burning propellant at a rate of 719 kilograms, or 1,585 pounds per second, traveling more than 9,500 kilometers, or 5,900 miles per hour, and located 112 kilometers, or 69 miles in altitude, and 116 kilometers, or 72 miles downrange. During ascent, the X-37B orbital test vehicle is protected inside a 5-meter diameter payload fairing. This 2-piece shell encapsulates both the Centaur upper stage and the X-37B. Once the vehicle is climbed above the densest part of Earth's atmosphere, the payload fairing is jettisoned. Following jettison of the payload fairing, propellant levels deplete and the booster engine shuts down. Following booster engine cutoff, the Atlas Centaur separation system activates to release the booster stage. The vehicle now weighs a little more than 15% of what it did at liftoff. The Centaur main engine is then started to begin second stage flight. Following main engine start, Centaur continues on to deliver the X-37B to begin its classified mission.
ULA is using the Atlas V 501 configuration to launch the X-37B. This is the 84th flight of the Atlas V rocket in ULA's 139th mission. Produced in ULA's 1.6 million square foot factory in Decatur, Alabama, the 501 is comprised of a Common Core booster powered by an RD-180 engine and a Centaur second stage powered by an Aerojet Rocketdyne RL-10C1 engine. A Ruag 5-meter diameter payload fairing protects the X-37B orbital test vehicle during ascent. On April 23rd, the Atlas V first stage was transported to the Vertical Integration Facility, or VIF, at Space Launch Complex 41, where cranes lifted the 33-meter or 107-foot-long booster onto the Mobile Launch Platform, or MLP. 2 days later, the pre-assembled interstage adapter, Centaur upper stage, and lower half of the payload fairing was delivered to the VIF and lifted atop the Atlas V booster. The stacking of the rocket was completed on May 5th, when the X-37B, encapsulated in a payload fairing, was mated to the Centaur. Atlas V launch countdowns begin with moving the rocket from the VIF to the pad. At approximately 10 a.m. Thursday, the quarter-mile trip began using 6 components to complete the 20-minute trip. Weighing in at about 2 million pounds, the Mobile Launch Platform, or MLP, supports the rocket and contains air conditioning, electrical, and commodities, while the undercarriages bear the weight of the MLP and rocket. Two rail cars lead the move, with the payload van providing communication to the payload, while the ground van houses the ground support for the rocket. At the rear of the convoy, the portable environmental control system provides air conditioning to the payload and rocket. Finally, track mobiles provide the power to move the convoy. The Atlas V rocket stands about 60 meters or 20 stories and weighs about 346,000 kilograms or 760,000 pounds fully fueled. The X-37B Orbital Test Vehicle is an experimental test platform managed by the Department of the Air Force Rapid Capabilities Office. Let's take a look at this unique program.
2019 at the forefront, touching down, speeding ahead, setting records for time and orbit. This is the X-37B, our country's only reusable space plane, project and pride of the U.S. Air Force and Boeing. It launches into low Earth orbit and stays there as needed for as long as it takes to get the job done. The X-37B has ensured America's superiority across air and space, and it's come home again and again and again. Poised to advance and grow, meeting critical challenges, it flies safely, autonomously, and sustainably. This is innovation moving humankind forward. This is the X-37B.
United Launch Alliance has successfully launched four previous orbital test vehicle missions. So let's look back at those missions as we count down to the next one. On April 22, 2010, the first flight of the Atlas V 501 rocket successfully launched the maiden flight of the Orbital Test Vehicle for the U.S. Air Force. Launched on March 5, 2011, the second OTV mission for the X-37B program was in support of space experimentation, risk reduction, and concept of operations development for long-duration and reusable space vehicle technologies. On December 11, 2012, ULA's Atlas V rocket again successfully boosted an X-37B into space. The rocket's 5-meter diameter payload fairing protected the OTV during an atmospheric ascent, and the Centaur upper stage injected the payload into the desired orbit. And ULA's fourth OTV mission launched on May 20th, 2015, from right here at Cape Canaveral. As we continue to do our part to slow the spread of COVID-19, protecting the health and the safety of the launch team is a top priority. We continue to follow CDC and local guidelines, including increased physical distancing between individuals sitting on console and wearing face coverings when practical. As I mentioned earlier, the USSF-7 launch carries a special dedication. Together with the Space Force, ULA is honoring healthcare workers, first responders, and other essential personnel on the front lines. And with this launch, we also stand in solidarity with those personally suffering or experiencing loss due to the virus. America Strong is a national salute to all those that have given so much during this pandemic. The Department of Defense and United Launch Alliance salute each American serving on the front lines in our fight against COVID-19. We are all in this together. Following liftoff, a few special guests will share their perspective on the role of our heroes in this fight. With today's flight, the Boeing OTV spacecraft team also wishes to remember one of their own who recently lost his battle with cancer. Vincent, or Vinny, De La Torre was a key member of the OTV propulsion team who served on the launch and recovery teams for more than a decade. Thank you, Vinny, for all you did to make Boeing and the OTV successful. Before we pull the team, let's watch a quick message from Leanne Corrette, President and CEO of Boeing Defense, Space, and Security.
To everyone supporting today's historic launch of the X-37B, thank you. On behalf of the entire Boeing company, I want to express my appreciation for your work to achieve this critical mission. Since the X-37B's launch in 2010, it has shattered all expectations. Every time it launches into space, it achieves firsts. And there is no other program that provides our nation an unrivaled capability to rapidly test and integrate new space technologies. None of these achievements would have been possible without your hard work and dedication. Good luck today. Thank you for everything you do. Stay safe and be well. Go Atlas, go Centaur, go SF7, and go X37B.
All minus 8 minutes.
LC on one. AC.
Go AC.
Ready to brief the LH2 storage tank liquid level arm.
LD, net one.
LD.
MD.
MD.
Proceed AC.
Okay, this poses no issues. Teams evaluator, we recommend forcing this measurement to be inactive. Method is to use option 354, and that would be done by fuel 2.
We remain in the planned 30-minute hold as we continue towards liftoff. In a few moments, launch conductor Dylan Rice will pull the launch team for the final go to pick up the countdown. 29 engineers and managers are pulled for system status and readiness to proceed. This is the final status check for all Atlas vehicle systems, ground systems, spacecraft, and the U.S. Space Force Eastern Range. The vehicle system readiness poll includes electrical systems, hydraulics, pneumatics, propulsion systems, flight control, and propellants. Let's listen in as Dylan Rice performs the final polling of the launch team.
Status check to proceed with terminal count, Atlas systems, propulsion.
Go.
Hydraulics.
Go.
Pneumatic.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
Water.
Go.
Centaur systems, propulsion.
Go.
Pneumatic.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
LH2. LH2.
Go.
Pass gas.
Go.
Electrical systems, airborne.
Go.
Ground.
Go.
Facility.
Go.
RFFTS.
Go.
Flight control.
Go.
GCQ.
Go.
Operation support.
Go.
Tom.
Go.
Umbilical.
Go.
ECS.
Go.
Red line monitor.
Go.
Quality.
Go.
Off safety manager.
Go.
ULA safety off.
Go.
Vehicle system engineer.
Go.
Anomaly chief.
Go.
Range coordinator.
No go for range weather LCCs.
Roger. LD.
5 minutes, 30 seconds.
No go with the range coordinator at a no go at this time.
Roger. And for the team on net one, we're going to stand by here. LC switch will remain not ready.
The range is currently no-go due to the violation of the cumulus cloud rule.
LC, LD on one.
Go, LD.
Please coordinate a new T0 of 12:34 Zulu.
Roger, 12:34 Zulu. RC, LC, net one.
RC.
Please coordinate a new T0 of 12:34 Zulu.
12134 Zulu, coordination work.
ALC, please set the clock for a new T0 of 1234 Zulu.
Roger, in work.
The launch time has now been rescheduled for 8:34 a.m. Eastern. This will be the end of the first window of opportunity.
LC, fuel 2.
Go, fuel 2.
I just wanted to confirm that Puma on 85 was force inactive.
Roger.
LC, RC, on one.
Go, RC.
New T0 is approved.
Roger.
In a few minutes, we'll re-poll the team to see if Atlas is ready to proceed. Currently, we're still in a hold based on the no-go for weather conditions for cumulus cloud violation in high winds.
L minus 8 minutes.
We remain in the planned 30-minute hold as we continue towards liftoff. Let's listen in as Dylan Rice performs the final polling of the launch team.
L minus 7 minutes.
LC, LD on one.
Go, LD.
Yeah, because of our constraints for the two weather conditions, we are going to move to the second window opportunity. Please coordinate a new T0 of 14:13:00 Zulu.
14:13:00 Zulu, roger. RC, LC, net one.
RC, go.
Please coordinate a new T0 of 14:13:00 Zulu with the range.
Copy.
ALC, please set the countdown clock for a new T0 of 14:13:00 Zulu. Roger.
This is Atlas Mission Control at T-minus 4 minutes and holding. We are not able to launch during our first window this morning due to the weather constraints. However, as I mentioned earlier, we do have a second 10-minute window available, and that window opens at 10:13 a.m. Eastern. So the rocket remains fueled, and the countdown will continue to hold at T-minus 4 minutes. For now, we'll take a break from our live coverage while we wait for the next window. Our coverage will resume at approximately 10:03 a.m. Eastern. We'll see you back here in about 90 minutes. This is Atlas Mission Control at T-minus 4 minutes and holding. Welcome back to the Atlas Space Flight Operations Center at Cape Canaveral in live coverage of the launch of USS F-7. We are approaching the opening of our second 10-minute launch window today at 10:13 a.m. Eastern. Liftoff did not occur during the first 10-minute window due to weather, and the weather continues to be no-go for the cumulus cloud rule, high ground winds, and the field mill rule, which governs the electrical potential in the air. The launch team has developed a plan to perform manual monitoring of the ground wind limit instead of relying on computer control that could trip the terminal count. Our normal wind monitoring watches for wind gusts from the start of terminal count at T-minus 4 minutes down to T-minus 11 seconds. We are manually monitoring those parameters now, starting at T-minus 3 minutes instead of T-minus 4, to shorten the amount of time we need to go without a gust to increase our chances of launching today. Jessica Williams, the 45th Space Wing's weather officer, recently updated the launch team on current weather conditions. The probability of violating launch constraints is 80%. The ground winds are 20 to 26 knots out of the northeast, and the temperature is 76 degrees Fahrenheit. As a reminder, the USS F-7 launch carries a special dedication. Together with the Space Force, ULA is honoring healthcare workers, first responders, and other essential personnel on the front lines. And with this launch, we also stand in solidarity with those personally suffering or experiencing loss due to the virus. America Strong is a national salute to all those who have given so much during this pandemic. The Department of Defense and United Launch Alliance salute each American serving on the front lines in our fight against COVID-19. We are all in this together. Following liftoff, a few special guests will share their perspective on the role of our heroes in this fight. We remain in the planned 30-minute hold as we continue towards liftoff. In a few moments, launch conductor Dylan Rice will pull the launch team for the final go to pick up the countdown.
L-minus 7 minutes.
Status check to proceed with terminal count. Atlas system. Propulsion.
Go.
Hydraulic.
Go.
Pneumatic.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
Water.
Go.
Centaur systems. Propulsion.
Go.
Pneumatic.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
LH2.
Go.
Hazgas.
Go.
Electrical systems. Airborne.
Go.
Ground.
Go.
Facility.
Go.
RFFTF.
Go.
Flight control.
Go.
DCQ.
Go.
Operation support.
Go.
Calm.
Com is good.
Umbilical.
Go.
ECS.
Go.
Redline monitor.
Go.
Quality.
Go.
Op safety manager.
Go.
ULA safety officer.
Go.
Vehicle system engineer.
Go.
Anomaly chief.
Go.
Range coordinator.
No go for range weather LCC violation.
Roger. LD, LC, net one.
LD on one.
Okay, with that no-go report, I recommend we set up for the end of the window.
I copy that. Stand by for coordination on that.
We're now resetting for a launch opportunity at the end of the window at 10:23 a.m. Eastern.
Go, LD.
Yeah, please coordinate a new T0 14:23:00 Zulu.
Roger, 1423 Zulu. RC, LC, net one.
Go.
Please coordinate a new T0 14:23:00 Zulu with the range.
Roger.
ALC, please reset the countdown clock for a new T0 14:23:00 Zulu.
Roger. LC, countdown clock set for new T0 of
LD, LC, net one.
LD on one.
Okay, per our previous discussion regarding the go pending for the end of the window, the plan would be to have the range coordinator report go pending, the final status check, and if the weather violations do not clear, have the range rock report no go at 60 seconds. Concur?
I concur.
Roger. RC, LC, one.
RC, go.
Okay, please coordinate a go pending with the ROC, having the ROC report no go if the weather constraints are not cleared at T minus 60 seconds.
Roger. And your T0 is approved.
Roger.
L minus 10 minutes. L minus 9 minutes.
As you can tell from our cameras, we're still encountering some weather issues, but we're still trying to get off at the end of the window today. The field mill rule has now been relaxed, but we're still fighting the cumulus cloud and high winds.
L minus 7 minutes.
Status check to proceed with terminal count, Atlas systems, propulsion.
Go.
Hydraulics.
Go.
Pneumatics.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
Water.
Go.
Centaur systems, propulsion.
Go.
Pneumatics.
Go.
LO2.
Go.
LH2.
Go.
Hazgas.
Go.
Electrical systems, airborne.
Go.
Ground.
Go.
Facility.
Go.
RFFDS.
Go.
Flight control.
Go.
GC Cube.
Go.
Operation support.
Go.
Calm. Umbilicals.
Go.
ACS.
Go.
Redline monitor.
Go.
Quality.
Go.
Op safety manager.
Go.
ULA safety officer.
Go.
Vehicle system engineer.
Go.
Calm.
Calm is...
Repeat.
Calm is go.
Roger. Anomaly chief.
Go.
Range coordinator.
Go pending.
Launch director.
Launch vehicle is ready to launch.
Mission director.
Mission director, you have permission to launch.
Proceeding with the count. ALC, verify T0 is set for 1423 Zulu.
Verified.
LC switch ready.
T-minus 5 minutes 30 seconds.
OS, start list data capture.
Roger.
The team has indicated they are go for launch, but this is pending range clear for the weather violations. Currently, the range is showing 90% probability of no go.
T-minus 4 minutes 30 seconds.
SMD, transfer spacecraft to internal power.
Roger.
All steps complete prior to terminal count.
On my mark, the time will be T minus 4 minutes and counting. 3, 2, 1 mark. T-minus 3 minutes, 55 seconds.
Ground pyro is enabled.
The countdown clock has resumed, and we are currently go pending for launch at 10:23 a.m. Eastern.
T-minus 2 minutes, 50 seconds.
Atlas tanks, flight pressure.
FTS internal.
T-minus 1 minute, 59 seconds.
Vehicle internal.
155.
Launch sequencer start.
150.
Securing Centaur LH2.
Securing Centaur LO2.
Hold, hold, hold. MEQ, liftoff ratio exceedance.
Clock has stopped at T-minus 1 minute 40 seconds. All personnel, enter the recycle steps. Operation 80.
LC, this is PNE-1.
Go PNE-1.
Atlas tank pressures are stable.
Roger.
LC, prop 1.
Go prop 1.
Propulsion and hydraulic systems are stable.
Roger.
LC is flight control.
Go flight control.
Flight control is ready to reset the clock to T-minus 4 in holding.
Roger. ALC, reset the countdown clock to T-minus 4 minutes and holding.
Roger.
LC, PNE-2, Centaur tank pressures are stable.
Roger.
LC is flight control.
Go.
SSVAPS inactive, FCS in free flight mode.
Roger.
LC, LD on 1.
Go LD.
MD has directed a scrub for today. Please prepare and recycle for a 24-hour turnaround.
Wilco.
This is Atlas Mission Control. It has been confirmed that we will not continue with USSF-7 launch activities this morning. We have a 24-hour recycle, so our next launch attempt will be tomorrow at 9:14 a.m. Eastern. For the most up-to-date information, please visit ulalaunch.com, follow us at ulalaunch, or call 1-877-ULA-4321. This concludes today's broadcast. I'm Tyler Strickland. Thank you for joining us.